Here is a Hunter 32500, allegedly carefree, low maintenance evaporative humidifier. This is an older product. I believe these came out in the late 90s. I remember my grandmother used to use one in the bedroom. I don't believe that she used it anymore. I don't know why she stopped using it. I'm sure my grandfather probably has it in the attic somewhere still. This one, I believe, is new in the box. Yeah, it looked like it's never been used. I remember seeing this unit over there when I was much younger. And, of course, I was intrigued by it because it had a fan. At my house, we had used the warm mist, you know, the boiling ones. And so that was all I knew. I had no idea how this thing worked at the time. So it says low maintenance, which is just total cap because these things are obscenely high maintenance and require constant cleaning all the time. I used to use the Delasco 1128 every year. I used that thing for quite a few years at the old location, and every couple of days you had to take the whole thing apart, soak it in bleach. Otherwise, it would get this slippery sludge everywhere, and you wake up with a sore throat. It was awful. The thing worked great. It was the only unit I was able to find that could humidify the bedroom properly, because it was forced hot air heating at that house, and so the problem with that is it exchanges the air in the room. So you humidify the room, and then the heat comes on, and all the humidity is gone. So I needed that, something that powerful, to keep up with that air change cycle. And then when I moved here, a tiny little warm mist one humidifies the bedroom with no problem, because it's baseboardy here, but I don't have that exchange of the forced hot air. So I actually haven't used the 1128 since I moved here. I thought about using it in the living room, because I heat with wood mostly, and wood is a very dry heat. It pulls a lot of moisture out of the house, and so it would be probably one of very few pieces that could actually keep the living room at a reasonable humidity level. The problem is the windows in there, the thermal properties are so poor that if you raise the humidity up past like 30% or so, the windows just start dripping water, which is not practical. So I find that I have to keep it only around like 20 or 25, which is enough to keep the static electricity down. It's not quite enough to feel comfortable, but it is what it is. So I have this here, and I figured when it gets really cold in the living room, like when it's really cold outside, rather, you know, 20, 10 degrees, and the fire's going real hot, I might use this in the living room for those nights, because the little warm mist ones just don't quite keep up when it gets that cold. So this says easy clean base, rounded corners are easy to wipe dry. That might be true. Five-year warranty, so it was pretty well-made product, allegedly. Most of the Hunter stuff was good quality. Adjustable humidistat, 5-gallon output, covers a 2,000 square foot area. Built-in antimicrobial properties to inhibit growth of bacteria, mold, and fungus. But the problem is, it's still going to grow. It even says, conduct routine maintenance and cleaning. So, this is a very similar design to the 1128 in the sense that it's got the pump in there that pumps the water over the filter, and then the fan draws the air over the filter. Number one humidifier system preferred 10 to 1 by surveyed physicians. Okay. You can tell this is old because the fan is wood and brass as opposed to silver. All right, let's take this out of the box, and I'm not going to put water in everything and make that kind of mess, but we'll go ahead and turn it on and see how it operates. Last side of the box. So this is some cap here, because cool mist is what this is, and it says growth of bacteria, mold, and plastic parts. No, but it is cool mist, which says yes. So that doesn't make any sense. Whatever. It's all lies, like so many other advertisements and product packaging and so forth. So I'm pretty sure that this is unused. The machine is still in the plastic here, although it looks like some of the packaging is missing. I think I have a second one of these that's actually sealed still. So we probably should open that one on video and see what that looks like. Yeah, this has definitely been opened at some point. But it does look like it's never been used, though. There's really not any evidence of, well, it might have had water in there once. There's a couple water specks on the side here, but it definitely does not look like it's really ever been used. Kind of dirty in here, like leaves or something in the bottom. That's kind of weird. Alright, so this is what we got here. The filter does feel like it was used. I would say this was used maybe once. Once or twice. So here's the allegedly easy to clean tray, but and you got all these little intricate. Oh, gross. So it says easy to clean corners, right? Okay, I can see that. But then what about all this and in there and in there? Like, this is not going to be easy to clean at all. And you can see there is a water line. So this was used a handful of times. I bet this accumulated from maybe just 2 or 3 days of use. I wouldn't be surprised if what happened is this was used, then it started smelling like mold, and so it stopped being used. Yeah, I just don't see how you can pass this off as easy to clean. I just don't see it. I'm trying to get a brush or a towel into the insides of there. Oh, but you can clean the corner. Well, that's great. But what about here? What about here? So these filters are just like a kind of like a paper material, and the water pours in on the top and it soaks through the filter. It's a very simple design. It's extremely effective. Just an issue with the cleanup. Now, admittedly, I have never used one of these with public water like we have here. We had well at the old house, and so I think that the well water probably is more prone to developing the bacteria or whatever it is that forms in there. So it would be interesting to run this with the public water here and see if it doesn't do that as much. It might not. The fan's got some pretty good pitch to it. But it's probably very loud because a lot of the airflow is blocked on the sides. Got the two speeds here. Actually feels kind of cheap. The old Hunter logo still. Here's the informations. One amps, made in China. Ooh. the bottom, we have the pump, which this is also another very difficult thing to clean. And then we have this hose, and it looks like we have a little filter up there, and all that stuff is very difficult to clean. We have a float switch here for the, it's kind of unintuitive, I think it should be the opposite. The motor is pretty much inaccessible. Yeah, this looks like it would be as equally as a pain in the neck to clean as the 1128 was. What I would often do is just fill the thing up with a very high concentration of bleach and let it run with the bleach in it. Alright, well, let's put the unit back together here. And we'll go ahead and turn it on. Hopefully it'll run without the water. It might not, because it's got the refill indicator, so we'll just have to figure out how to bypass that. Or we just need to tape. See, this is confusing to me, because I would think as the water level rises, right, this would get pushed up. But the spring is pulling it up. You can hear that. So I wonder if maybe this is why it stopped being used. Well, I have a hunch this might just run, because that seems like it's messed up to me. Is this backwards? It looks symmetrical to me. I guess it's not symmetrical. Alright, let's get the kilowatts meter going here so we can get the power information. volts. And this is a shaded pole PSC motor. That's one thing I'll give the 1128. It had a full PSC motor apparatus as opposed to the cheesy shaded pole design. Okay. Let's go ahead and plug this in. Okay, it does say refill, so I guess the switch is working, but I don't understand the logic of it. To me, that's backwards. Well, where are those, I just used them the other day and now they've disappeared. I had little clips that I was going to stick on here. See if we can, fool this like this. I really don't understand the logic of this thing whatsoever. It does not make any sense to me in the slightest. Alright, that should work. It doesn't say refill anymore, but it's also off. No, it still says refill. So, I guess I'm just kind of confused as to how this works. It says refill if this is down, and it says refill if it's up. And you can hear the click is all the way at the end. I don't get it. Unless, is there some other way that it senses the water? Yeah, see, if it's all the way up, it works. So why then, if we turn it like this, it does not work? It does not. I guess it does fall, but not much. It falls just a hair. Okay, so now I understand what the problem is. You know what? We're just gonna write it like this. It's starting to become too much trouble. Now, of course, this is probably moving a lot more air than it normally would because it doesn't have the resistance of the filter. If it wasn't for the bearings or whatever that scraping noise is, it actually would be reasonably quiet. This is 0.61 amps, 47 the watts with a power factor of 0.64. It is horrifically out of balance. That's a huge jump up in speed. Oops, that's 0.96 amps, 70 the watts, the power factor is 0.61. And that's moving a lot of air. But again, it might be reduced once the filter's in place. Is this adjustable? Yeah, this is adjustable too. That actually has a considerable effect. The bearings seem fairly free still. All right, well, this works. It's going to need a good clean out because it does have a little bit of, I guess it does have a little bit of use on it. But I think next year I might try this out for occasional use in the living room.